Welcome to the video, everyone. Welcome to the video. Was having a very animated discussion in public place about the movie Back to the Future and how it predicts the Cubs winning the World Series. Cubs winning the World Series in 2015. World Series ring there by the Giants. So we finished this discussion, and it's a very intense day. I'll get in more into that later. So we leave the public place and swing out on the freeway, okay? So, following this car on the freeway, as soon as I pull onto the freeway, I'm behind this car, okay. Then I look at the car and I say, hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I do a double take. I said, come on, this can't be possible, right? What do you think I was following on the freeway as I pulled onto the freeway? Any guesses? Yeah, there you go. This exact car, not the same license plate, of course, but this is the McLaren, I believe. What's it called? The John McLaren. DeLorean. DeLorean. John Z. DeLorean. It's the DeLorean. This is the car I was following on the freeway. When's the last time I even saw a DeLorean on the road? Now, what does this have to do with anything? This is the car that was used for time travel in Back to the Future. The movie Back to the Future was, which brought us to the Cubs winning the World Series. Cubs win! Cubs win! So, how astonishing is that? I haven't seen a DeLorean in decades. I mean, you just don't see them anymore. Right after this big, big issue of how important, you know, this, that we're in this time of Back to the Future movie and everyone's talking about Back to the Future and wow, what's going on here? I pull on the freeway behind a DeLorean. And I have witness to this. It is not being made up. This is, so I was just like, whoa, wow. No, sorry, not whoa, wow, 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 wow. The odds in that are just impossible, you know, to calculate. The exact timing of it all. Exact car. Okay. So, something is going on, I can tell you. There's a lot going on right now, and we're right on it, okay? And it's an emergency. Now, last video I said we need to go back to 1980, 1980, 1981, that type of baby, you know, end of 1980, beginning of 1981. So that mindset. I asked someone, how much you think I weigh yesterday? They said, I think 181 pounds. I said, what? And then later I'm doing the video, 81. Oh my gosh, 81. I said, look up 81. What happened in 81? Well, we're supposed to go back prior to computing the road that goes down into the artificial intelligence road, okay? Well, it just so happens, if you go back to that time, what do we find out? And this is quite astonishing, and it gets even more astonishing. You know what we find in August 12th, 1981? We find the IBM PC 5150. This is the PC that truly started all. I mean, Radio Shack, Tandia, Commodore, whatever, you know, Apple II. You know, those were hobbyist kind of stuff. This was the first mass-produced, globally distributed. This is what started personal computing. This is what took us down the road to artificial intelligence. This is the IBM 5150. It first debuted in August, I believe, August 12th, 1981. Okay. This is just astonishing, but it gets even more astonishing. Do you know that the police code for 5150 means a dangerously insane person, danger to himself, dangerous to others, dangerous to property, dangerous, dangerous, dangerous psycho on the loose? Okay. 5150. Van Halen put their album title 5150. And yeah, so this computer is named IBM 5150. 5150. And of course, Apple computer, they use that the Apple logo with a bite out of it, saying, don't, you know, in the Garden of Eden, don't take a bite out of the fruit in the middle of the garden, which many people said was an apple. So they use this apple taking a bite out of forbidden fruit. You're not supposed to do this, but it's supposed to go down the route of artificial intelligence. And then you have the first really mass produced and globally recognized personal computer, IBM 5150. Crazy, insane, dangerous situation. Now, if that's not an attention getter, what's going on here? We need to go back before artificial intelligence, before that road to artificial intelligence got really started, back prior to August 12th, 1981, okay? With our consciousness, our mindset, so we can evaluate, hey, maybe we didn't, there was another path and we didn't notice it. Well, guess what the two paths are called? The path of worshiping time and the path of honoring time. Those are the two paths. There are two paths. The Bible calls it the goats and the sheep. The goats are the one who are worshiping time. They're worshiping time hoping that, you know, that they can make time real. The ones honoring time realize that time can never be real. It was just an idea gone like that. And that path is the path of setting, of ending, you know, our honoring of time. We honor it and then we let it go and that's it. Okay. Whereas worshiping time is no, let's keep on, and something can come with us. We can be happy just worshiping time. This is our life. This is our destiny to worship time. Honoring time, path of honoring time knows this is not our destiny. This is not what God created us for. We have to ultimately set down this honoring of time and get back to functioning the way we're created to function. So these paths are very different. They begin to diverge, and they go off like that. And so this is what's happening in the world. The difference in the people in this world, and they're not people, they're spirits pretending to be people, is either you're on the path of worshiping time or you're on the path of honoring time. Here, honoring time is the path we're on. And now, like in the Roman Empire, let's say the Roman Empire was attacking Gaul, or they're warring against some area there, conquering it. And well, the people in Rome, you know, if they're winning the war, the people say everything's fine, everything's great, I mean, life's great, you know, no, what problem? We don't have any problems. Well, the Gauls who are being conquered, they might be having problems, right? So if there's a war going, the ones who are winning it, they say, what's the big deal? There's no problem. Yeah, but the ones who are losing the war, there's a big problem. This is unfortunately the mindset of the world. Those who are into worshiping time think, oh, you know, but things are going great. We've got Agenda 21 that'll really help us next 15 years become even more dedicated time worshippers. So, I mean, I like the way that everything's trending. This is what they'll say. Everything's trending in a really good direction here. Of course, those who are on a path of honoring time is saying, hey, this is terrible. This is terribly detrimental to our momentum, what we're about. Right, so, you know, if you try to talk to time worshippers, they just don't know what you're talking about. And another thing is, time worshippers don't even acknowledge there is another path. They still don't say, no, this is the only path there is. What are you talking about? This is going to succeed. This is what we really want. This is it. There's nothing else. And so they don't feel a need to be spiritually literate about the other path. Okay, whereas those who are on the path of honoring time, they have to be very literate about this. Plus, they're living in a world which is overwhelmingly into worshiping time, so they have to be aware of that too. So much greater strain and difficulty. So, you know, what I've been trying to do is help everyone get literate about the path of honoring time. Get the spiritual literacy. You have to be literate about this. You have to be able to talk about it. You have to be able to understand it. You have to be able to see where we're coming from here. And those who are worshiping time, they say, oh, why should I do that? The path doesn't exist. It's just a fantasy. Just made it up. Worshiping time is the only game in town. The better to focus in on it. Of course, they're going to say that because it doesn't work. So they feel, well, I got to focus in on it even more. So I just got to exclude any other focus. You know, and this is the world right now. Time worshippers tend to want to exclude any other focus or even admit there could possibly be another focus. And nothing else could possibly work but just worshiping time, which, of course, never works. Never works. Because time doesn't exist. This is all just a worshiping of time. This whole situation, existence, a memory, in memory of time, which never existed except for an instant of the idea. Could it exist? But no, it cannot. Concretization cannot exist. Lack of freedom cannot exist in reality. So Certainly, those who are honoring time are under enormous duress. There's a severe emergency crisis there, you know, because the world is about ready to just say, hey, there isn't any other option. And if you think there is, you're crazy. This is the trouble. So I've been hitting the emergency button for a long time, but now I'm just like leaning on the horn. And so I said, hey, let's go back to 1980 or even 81. That time, let's say we can even say 81, before, just before the personal computer. Interesting. So, that's interesting. I'm going to check something out here, if you just bear with me. And we're going to ask for spiritual shepherding and to show us this other option, introduce this other option, make it more clearer to us, and say, how can we go down this road and check this road out, in a, you know, better than we've been doing, that's for sure. So this is what has been indicated is necessary. So I said, hey, you know, 1981, who was a great shepherd alive at that time? Well, again, Nanamai Ma was. And she's been showing up in dreams, saying that she's available, that she's back, and she's, you know, just indicating some very strong willingness to help. I said, wow, well, this is great. Last night, after I did this video about going back and asking for help, the intense dreams of Anandamayi Ma. Very, very, very amazing. It's like, okay. Wow. If we recognize, you know, the emergency of the times, then we cry out stronger and more demanding, and this gets listened to. You know, we're not joking. That we are under incredible duress. The Bonn Conference, starting the 19th through the 23rd, which is going to finalize the global legally binding agreements to turn this world into essentially a environmental activist globe. This is what's coming. Now, this is all about worshiping time, 100% about worshiping time. So we're saying, hey, we want to get going on our pathway of honoring time. But honoring time doesn't need this planet, actually. It doesn't need this planet. The death-free realm is good enough for honoring time. It doesn't need all this nonsense here of sickness and dying and death and situations, circumstances, all this fake evidence. It's all this fake evidence. It doesn't need it. I'm going to check something out here. So we got to get going on that path. This is very, very, very crucial. Okay, very good. We have to get going on our path. So, super emergency right now. I'm calling a super emergency in Bonn in 2 days now is going to be the finalizing of the climate change agreement, which will then just the official ceremony of all the nations signing it and congratulating. We know that it's going to take place in Paris, essentially. You know, there'll be some wrangling, whatever, but what they're trying to do is get agreed to it ahead of time, so it's all ironed out, and everybody can come there and shake hands and schmooze and conferences and dinners and pat each other on the back and say, okay, we finally got it figured out. Now we're full throttle to worshiping time, you know. This October meeting is what's essential, and actually the Sustainable Development Summit in September 25th through 27th, the 2:15 that the Pope attended, and the President, U.S. President, gave a speech, and China and all the big leaders of the world gave speeches. There is a big deal, and they agreed to the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. This was actually designed to give enormous push to this Bonn pre-Paris COP21 Conference of Party Climate Change Summit to give a final push to Bonn to finalize the everything in there, an agreement, legally binding agreement. That's why it was so important. This is coming up in 2 days' time. So hopefully some of you are somewhat literate about what we've been talking about and getting this feeling like, yeah, I can kind of hang with this. Because you can't just pull yourself up by the bootstraps in the last instance, like someone trying to learn, you know, Mandarin Chinese right in this instant. You can, you know, got tomorrow you got to be absolutely fluent in Mandarin Chinese. I don't think I can do that. So this is why preparation ahead of time was so important. This is why I've been taping, saying, you know, get fluent, somewhat fluent in all of this stuff. So you can follow the path, this alternative pathway that we didn't really take so seriously. Now, you go back to 1980, 1981, 79, 80, I was looking at the songs in those years. Holy cow. I mean, this is a time, I don't know, it was just like, we were not paying attention, you know? We were not paying attention. Let me see something. The world was partying. It was in the disco party mood, and it was pretty insane time in a lot of ways. Holy cow, wait a minute, let me see something here. Holy cow, folks, get this, wow. AIDS, I looked up the timeline of AIDS. 1981, on June 5th, 1981, U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, published a morbidity and mortality weekly report describing cases of a rare lung infection in five young, previously healthy gay men in Los Angeles. Okay, so this is picked up on June 5th, began reporting this. June 6th, San Francisco Chronicle covered the story. So it was in June of 1981 that the AIDS epidemic broke out. So what I'm saying is prior to that, okay, and of course this took a while to roll out, you know. By year's end, there was a cumulative total of 270 reported cases of severe immune deficiency among gay men, and 121 of those individuals had died. So it started entering the consciousness in 1981. Prior to that, 1981, it was party time. It was sexual liberation. It was crazy. It was Donna Summer, you know, dominating the charts of the disco. It just, you know, just it was just a very crazy, erotic time, so to speak, of sort of like the end of the world. People were just a little nuts, to say the least. It was, you know, because the plague of AIDS had not arrived yet. Birth control had arrived, you know, and people were just becoming, you know, fornicators, to say the least. And it's this extreme eroticism of that time which I believe made us drop the ball, and we just sort of said, hey, let's just kind of float into this timeline of artificial intelligence. Maybe that'll make us even feel even more eroticized and, you know, into time worshiping. So we dropped the ball at that point. This is where we dropped the ball. So it all happened in 81. The personal computer exploded on the scene, and AIDS exploded on the scene, both in the summer of 1981. So we want to go back prior to the summer of 1981, okay? And we want to say, let's take another look. Give us another chance, okay? Okay, now we're calm, we're cool, we're in the wow, okay? We're in the wow. We've knocked out eroticism, we've knocked out all that time worshiping. Let's take a second look and see the pathways, and let's see if we can choose once again. Yeah, Disco Inferno at that time. And people were popping, using drug cocaine like crazy. That's another thing, when the cocaine epidemic hit, that must have been in the late 70s, I would say, probably. I can look that up, too. Because people were just absolutely just partying like crazy. 70s. Okay. Definitely in the 1970s, 80s, and 90s, that was the decades of cocaine. This really caused people to, you know, not make wise choices, okay? And like I've said, I've never touched it. This is a history of, I don't want that one, history of the United States. But it provided the energy for the disco thing, which was roaring along, and then until AIDS came into the picture. And by that time, the personal computer was there, and people transitioned into artificial intelligence. So, and in fact, it was cocaine that fueled artificial intelligence. Living here in Silicon Valley, I can report to you that this is that and caffeine, cocaine, caffeine, are these drugs that fueled the programmers and the geeks stay up all night, and they just, you know, pushed it like crazy. And this was a drug of choice in these computer companies. Okay, let's see. If I can find this, they're going into too much detail here. Okay. The second epidemic of cocaine was interesting. 1, 2, and 3. So in the United States, the first cocaine epidemic was in the 1920s. For the next 4 decades, cocaine was a triply marginal drug in the United States. So it was 1920s, okay, the roaring 20s. That is very interesting. Then there was a second extreme cocaine epidemic, which was in the 1970s, started in the 1970s. Okay. Started low doses in 1969. Explosive growth of smoking crack was in the mid-1980s. Okay. We were right in the middle of this cocaine epidemic, no question about it. So, there you have it. There you have it. The population was drugged out. They were in this roaring sexual freedom, cocaine use, time, partying, staying up all night, discoing, partying, dressing. I mean, there was just, you know, this riotously party time in the late 1970s and into the early 1980s. This was the peak of it. If you look at, again, the songs, it's like, wow. Every song is just this. I realized, you know, let's party, disco, drug, sex song is just like crazy. And so we were not paying attention. The globe was not paying attention. It was distracted. It was supremely distracted. We have this whole thing that the artificial intelligence tapped into this, the whole cocaine culture and party, disco, party culture. Said, hey, this is cool gadgetry, you know, and if this is how it began to creep into us, because the world was drugged. Heavily, the drug use, especially among affluent baby boomers, was extreme, actually. It was very accepted, very chic, along with unrestrained immorality also. Put the two of those together, you're going to drop the ball. You're going to drop the ball. You're under influence of caffeine, cocaine, and immorality. You're going to drop the ball, and here comes this very seductive computer with nice graphics, you know, and it's like, oh wow, this is cool. It's kind of like a disco tech, you know. This is cool stuff. So we just kind of started wandering down this road as a planet. We started wandering down this road, saying, hey, maybe there's a party down here. Maybe we can get our groove thing on here, you know, boogie boogie boogie, boogie fever, and yeah, that's exactly what happened. Before we knew it, you know, that we're doing all this cool graphics, and then, you know, the video stuff comes out, camcorders start coming out, and all this cool, you know, cool stuff, and we'd say, hey, we could eye candy, and it went on and on and on and on, and then it gets into business, of course. Now here we are, 2:15, and we're staring straight in the face of this, you know, artificial intelligence Godzilla that's about ready to devour us, at least become the idol of time worshippers. And, you know, we're saying, whoa, I think we've gone far enough down this road. And so how do we back up? Well, we're doing it right here. first of all, we know at that time there was somebody capable of setting us straight in this world, okay? Nanda Mayama died August 27th, 1982. So, there was somebody present that could definitely have set us straight if we would have asked her. Absolutely. We didn't. Apparently we didn't, you see. So, but we have a second chance, actually. We have a second chance. I mean, there's somebody actually on this planet. Of course, any great spiritual teacher can set us straight. But the fact there was actually some, you know, one of these great teachers right here on this planet who could have set us straight and we didn't listen. Wow. That's how drugged out and messed up everybody was. I mean, boogie boogie fever. Donna Summer fever, so to speak. Not picking on her at all. It's just bringing up, you know, if you were there, you understand. So, we now have what I see an opportunity to go back and get some advice and say, hey, we can reconnect with the spiritual shepherding that was present in prior to the summer of 1981. And say, okay, let's take a second look now at the two pathways, time worshiping and honoring a time. I want to take a very clear now. I'm clear enough to take a look at these paths, and let's look at them together. You know, let's take a look at this here. This is very important. We don't want to keep going down the pathway of artificial intelligence. We were led down the primrose path very, very severely. And I'm just bringing to light the cultural reasons for this, along with the sort of collapsing of religion in this world, especially in the West, where people start saying, hey, you know, that's not groovy enough for me. And and of course, it wasn't clear enough. It didn't clearly point out the past clearly enough. You have a bunch of evangelists, and now you have the Catholic Church under Pope Francis, ex-Pope Francis, Francis Emeritus, and you have that, and the evangelicals are now jumping on the ecological bandwagon too, because they're inveterate time worshippers. Let's be honest about it. Most religions are time worshippers. Most religion is all about time worshiping, saying that God created bodies, God created world, God created time, space, process, form, God created all this. This is what we are, and we need to worship this because we worship nature. We're worshiping God. You know, these are time worshippers. So of course we're going to drop the ball under all this influence. What was going to help us see that the pathway of honoring time, which is what Jesus talks about in A Course in Miracles. By the way, A Course in Miracles came out in about the beginning of the cocaine epidemic. I think in 1976 it was first available in bookstores, I believe. It could have been a little later than that. In 1978, I got my 3 volumes out of A Course in Miracles, began studying it in the summer of 1978, which helped me realize there's some alternative to this insanity that's going on, okay? Otherwise, I wouldn't be here. For sure, I wouldn't be here. I mean, it was crazy back then. The distraction was off the hook. And then we were so distracted, we didn't even see the alternative to artificial intelligence, the pathways at that time. But we're not so distracted right now. So, this seems to be gathering momentum. Okay, it seems to be gathering momentum. And actually, this Back to the Future thing is becoming huge right now in the world. They're reissuing the trilogy because everybody's talking about it. You know, it's like, what's going on here? I was like, how long ago was that? The movie, 27 years ago or something, that the movie was made, and they're going to, you know, nail the Cubs winning the World Series. I mean, this is a little, this is peculiar to everybody. They're saying, hey, you know, wow. There's some wow factor. There's a wow factor going on right now in the world, because I think a lot of people are realizing, hey, we don't really want artificial intelligence. Keep going down that path. But we're not sure, is there an alternative path? Well, I'm saying I believe there is. And we dropped the ball. We had the option. We had the option. We still do. But, you know, we wasted a lot of time going down the path of how many years has it been? 1980, let's say 1980 till now, 35 years, right? 81, we get 34 years. We've spent that time checking out the path of artificial intelligence, and now we're saying, okay, hold on, what that? Just 1 minute, boys, you know, not so fast. We're going to go back and take a look at the other path here. Now, I introduced the idea that the great spiritual helpers of the world, being totally free of any time worshiping or time honoring, and being perfectly clear about it, but also being able to appear as if they were at least honoring time and show up for us, because they're honoring our creativity by doing so, which is fine with us, fine with them, it's wonderful. They can appear and then disappear, just because their body dies doesn't mean that they cannot still appear. And like I said before, you can see one of them die, but that doesn't mean their spiritual appearance has died at all. And they can reappear anytime they want to, like Jesus did. Jesus reappeared. Okay? So, we have access to these teachers. And this is what I'm saying. I've been believing this my whole life. We have access to them. It's only our distraction that makes us unaware of this. We think, oh no, we got to keep going down this pathway of artificial intelligence. No, we don't. We can say, hey, I want some help. Help us out. Showcase the other path, the path of honoring time. Showcase that to us. Show us how that goes. And this is, of course, what Jesus did in A Course in Miracles and Journey Beyond Words. Showcase that. Help us out with that so we can make a choice here. We have a choice, you see, which way we go. The sheep are the goats. So this is what I've been working on. I'm trying to keep everyone's assurance, say, hey, there has to be a way where we can make a choose once again, all right? And decide, I like this path of honoring time better than worshiping time. Don't like being a time worshiper, that is for sure. That is for sure. Honoring time is the path that helps us get home, really, to, you know, true abidance and the isness of our freedom. And time worshiping is the path of avoiding that, trying to delay and avoid that terrible path. You know, really, at some point you're going to say, wow, this just stinks, I don't like it anymore. Now, getting back to this very interesting article I just saw on cocaine, the dream I had that where everything collapsed on Highway 111, 111. World Series coming up, October 27th starting. This is very interesting. That in that dream there was three collapses, actually. Collapsing. What does that mean? Maybe if you look at it spiritually, you mean we drop the ball. And took a path we shouldn't have taken at that point. So there may have been three points of divergence off the right, the way path of honoring time instead of worshiping time. There's no question that dream is three times. The first one was pretty like shocking, like wow, but we sort of recovered from that and said, okay, I guess we're okay. And then the second one was stronger, and in this dream, and we were just like, oh wow, that was really intense. I don't know how, but we found a way to recover from that, but it was really quite nasty. Then the third one was completely overwhelming. And I don't know how anyone's going to recover from that one. Be quite a recovery. And we just find out there's three cocaine epidemics in the United States. And the time frame they use is very interesting because it looks very similar time frame in the dream that I had. First one, the 1920s, second one, the 1970s and 80s. The third one could be coming now. And it wouldn't necessarily have to be cocaine epidemic. It could be... What it's showcasing is a extreme distraction based on drugs, I would say, based on drugs. And the time frame that the between those two, 1920, 1970, 50 years, and 1970, 2015, 30, 45 years, 1980 would be 35 years. That's exactly what was in the dream I had. That kind of, I noticed a sort of a time frame, a way of saying, okay, this one happened, there's a break, and then another one happened, there's another break, and then the big one happened. So the big one would be something where we would lapse so badly, collapsing, that we don't even recognize there's an option at all. We are just really, really, really confused, dazed and confused, and not aware of it. After the first one, we were able to get back some awareness. After the second one, well, yeah, but I say I've been able to get awareness back. Very difficult. After this third one, it might be prohibitively difficult. So we are making astonishing progress here right now. This is exciting. Had extensive interaction with Ananda Maimon last night. Very intense, extensive. It was just full on. I mean, it was just amazing, and very, very, very clear. It was spiritual, absolutely spiritual, and the look, the intensity, the vibe, everything was there. And I said, "Wow, this is really extraordinary." And it's all about, it's not about the person, it's not about the image or the, it's about the spiritual path of honoring time, which is really honoring our creativity, so that we can set it down and move on from it, truly move on from it, and say, okay, enough is enough. Okay, we've done enough honoring. We don't need to keep honoring the memory of time. It's kind of like if someone has a woman who has a stillborn pregnancy, okay, very tragic. And let's say they had all the clothes picked out, the crib, the wallpaper, everything was ready, baby showers, everything. Then the child is born stillborn. This is very, very, very traumatic. And so, they might say, "Oh, well, we have to bury the child." Oh, we understand that, but we're going to, for a while, we're going to act as if the child was actually born properly and is actually here, and we're going to maybe keep the room the way that it all was, and all the clothes and the carriages and everything, and pretend that it actually happened, that there's really it was a real birth, a live birth. And someone's really hurts them so bad, they may spend a lot of time, maybe years, acting as if that child's alive, maybe even talking to the child, coming in and pretending to care for it, and going through the motions because they were completely ready to do this, and suddenly it doesn't happen. They may just go ahead and act it out. And you wouldn't blame them for that, would you? You wouldn't. You understand. Now, if you take it to an excess, then that's a problem, right? Let's say, 10 years later, they're still acting like that there's a 10-year-old child in the room is not there. But for maybe, a little while, yeah, they're honoring, their hope that what would hope the hope that would happen. But if it keeps going on for 10 years, then you'd say, well, they're worshiping this. This is an idolatry worship situation. There's some, disorder here. So this is very similar to what we're talking about. The worshiping of time indicates a severe disorder of extreme continuity fear, and unwillingness to even start dealing with that. It's time. It's time to let go of time, so to speak. And then honoring it would be, hey, for a while we'll go through the motions, and yeah, but we realize, hey, we got to let this go at some point. So I'm just doing this in order to let it go. All right, this is fine. This is fine. This is mental health, actually. It would be a little odd for a woman to bury a stillborn child and not go through a grieving period and looking at all the things that she got in the baby shower and got prepared. May have spent years getting ready for this, as her whole life was focused on this, and they're just snatched away at the last second. It's understandable. So, the So the belief in time, our time was stillborn, okay, for us. Nothing happened. Nothing. It's an idea that has no experiencing of it, really. So, because it's trying to change reality. So, but we thought, oh, you know, maybe this was something great for us to experience. So we go through this sort of mourning period, honoring of time, but eventually it's time to let go of this. So this is the path of honoring time, but the path of worshiping time is quite different. It's an aberration, and you know we should be getting over that by now, but most are not. They are not. They're continuing on with this, fueled by drugs, licentiousness, immorality, all this kind of stuff. So I would say that coming up soon is going to be an unprecedented time in a lot of ways of distraction, extreme licentiousness and immorality and drug use. Certainly are part of it, but there's way more to it. Extreme activism also. And who knows what else, but it's the worst ever. It's the worst distraction ever coming up. Now, there may be some new drug come out, actually. I know women have some sex pill now that has come out to drive, you know, continuous desire in them. So this may be part of it. That's just been okay by the FDA. We're going to have just this incredible time of distraction coming up. Very bad. Want to sidestep it. And I recall very well that I don't hardly recall the 80s because it was so bizarre. It's like you're holding on. Say, I don't want to slip into this. This is terrible. If I slip into this, I'm finished. You know, I'm finished. But yet, having survived the 80s, time to go back to prior to the computer thing, and thinking that maybe that's a way to. It's like an anchor, a lifeboat. It was a lifeboat. Oh, computers, yeah, let's get into that lifeboat. Well, it was the wrong lifeboat to get into, actually, to say the least. It's almost like there was a terrible storm then, so we'd be looking for a lifeboat, and oh, along comes this lifeboat that may have generated the storm in the first place, and we jump into that artificial intelligence lifeboat. Now we're saying we're up a creek without a paddle. We're saying, hey, what do we do? Well, we have an answer here. Because time doesn't really exist at all. So there's nothing preventing us from shifting our focus back prior to, you know, summer of 1981. Not that we'd be hallucinating or anything that necessary, anything like that, but our consciousness can shift back there. As if the last 35 years or so really never happened, you know, or it's just like a memory. It's a fading memory. It's not important. It's not really important. Because we said we already went down this road. We realized we don't want this. Therefore, you know, okay, set this aside. We're setting that aside. We're sidestepping that option now. Because we're going down another road. This is honoring time, which leads is a sort of a period where we let go of, you know, of this whole shock of time, believing in time and realizing we can't experience it, and the continuity fear. We let go of all this. We work through it. And it's very interesting that this movie came out about going back and forth into the future and then back, and then into the future and then back like this. Maybe it's introducing the fact, hey, we can actually do this in some way. Not the same way as the movie did, but our consciousness in some way. "1980" was the number one song. I think it was "Call Me" by Blondie. But, you know, of course that was used in American Gigolo in an immoral, very immoral way. But if you give it, you could give it another spin of the lyrics. Call me anytime. Give me a call anytime. You know, I'll be there, so to speak. If you look at it spiritually, it could be spirit saying, you can call 1980 again, and I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you spiritually. You see, the option is still there. How about that? And I think reminiscing the song I talked about you last night, this is and on the way back home, I promise you, you'll never be alone. That was in 1980. I believe that song was in 1980. Maybe. Or is that 79? Maybe it's at 79, maybe 80 was Cool Change, Time for a Cool Change. I think Cool Change was maybe 1980, and Reminiscing was 1979. Little River Band, very powerful songs. Time for a Cool Change, well, unfortunately we jumped into artificial intelligence right after that, 1980. But I promise you, on the way back home, I promise you, you'll never be alone. So this time frame, 79, 80, 81, right there. This was the crucial time. And then again, I came across A Course in Miracles in the summer of 1978, which was all important, saved me, absolutely saved me. Because the world was going down the wrong path, going down the path of time worshiping, with the United Nations greasing the skids, of course. As they are greasing the skids in a couple days now. So, you know, we need to be saved from that right now, actually. We need kind of an A Course in Miracles moment at this point, to tell you the truth. I remember that very well, going into Walden Pond Bookstore and going up in the spiritual loft area. Well, they had a great spiritual selection of books up there. It's astonishing. And pulling out this books, the bright blue covers, and A Course in Miracles. I said, what in the world is this? Started trying to read it and said, wow, I've never come across anything like this before. I thought I was super well read, which I was, astonishingly well read, and yet this was something different. I realized right away, this is something different. This is got some escape velocity to it, like really powerful. So I got to take a look at this. And eventually I came back and bought it. You know, it was all the money I had, I think, in the world. And that was it. The rest is history. very turbulent times we had in the world since then, hasn't it been? Yeah. Again, June, what was it, June 7th, AIDS epidemic, something like that. June 12th, 1981. 1981 really was a pivotal year, wasn't it? And we really didn't know. We need to forgive ourselves. You know, the world was not, you know, even if you were trying to stay on the straight and narrow path, everybody was cuckoo. The whole world was just a little bit out of their minds. And, you know, paying attention was not hip at that time. So we wandered down the wrong path. That's okay. There's a lot of Pied Pipers helping us out. So forgive yourself. Say, okay, let's do redo here. Let's take two on this. And let's assess our options once again. Why not? So we need A Course in Miracles like moment where you come across something and you just say, wow, this has unprecedented escape velocity, no question about it. This is what we need right now. We're in a desperate need for that. And you know, the goats, those are the time worshippers, are now realizing their time is here, and it's time for them. So they're taking a hard line right now. They say, hey, we don't have to put up with time honorers anymore. We got the power, we got the juice, we can get rid of them. And they're taking a very hard line right now. I'm experiencing this myself, unfortunately, putting myself in a very, very drastic, insecure situation. We knew this time would come, the separation of the sheep and the goats, and that the goats don't like the sheep at all. They wish the sheep would just, you know, die. So this is the pressure that I'm under right now, terrible pressure. So we need a Course in Miracles-like moment of coming across the Course in Miracles. Most people have come across it, remember when they first came across it, and they said, wow. It was like an astonishing wow. And we said, this is a game changer right here. This is a true game changer, and it's turned out to be correct. And yet, we need another game changer right now, actually. And it's great to be in this intensity, isn't it? The United Nations having their 70th birthday party on October 24th, 2015, is a big deal, because they're feeling their power now. They're feeling that it's going their way. They're feeling time worshiping has won the battle. And this is going to add a tremendous momentum to the whole situation, actually. I think there are other corollaries of the 24th, but the 27th is when the World Series starts. And my anniversary of Ananda, my mom actually let me know that she still exists, because she died in, the body died in 1982, August 27th, and yet in October 27th, 1997, she contacted me and let me know that she's part of some plan to help us out, and don't think that she's gone. You know, she said, made it very clear, I'm still very much here, still very much aware, and working very much to help out those who are on the path of honoring time, spiritual rites, spiritual practice. And let's do something about this. Can you help me out? Help me do something about this. Well, yeah, I was just like, whoa, what is this? What's going on here? So it's taken me a long time to, you know, try and work through a lot of issues and see what's going on. But it's coming to light now, isn't it? It's coming to light. We made a bad choice. It's that simple. Under the influence. Sex, drugs, and rock and roll. We're under the influence. The world was. We don't live in a vacuum. Collectively, you know, it doesn't. It's like, you know, if you're trying to, you know, it's like, let's say you're not drinking, you're sober, but all the people you're around are raving drunk. It's very hard for you to maintain a sober state of mind, even though you're not drinking at all. It's almost impossible. Like playing golf with those two yahoos who were drunk and spraying the ball. Like I ended up playing as bad as they were playing almost. You know, eventually I got it back together a little bit, but it ruined my golf game. So even if you're sober, if everyone else is drunk, you know, you're cooked. You're cooked. It's a terrible situation. Unless you have some really, really great help. Someone who cannot be influenced in any way, and that, you know, which is rare. If we'd asked, we'd have gotten help. Yogananda said, hey, Nanda Maimon, why don't you come over to America? And she says, well, if they want me over there, this in God's will, I'll go over there, sure. Well, apparently, didn't want her to come over here. So, you know, it's a mistake. If we made mistakes. You want great teachers to help out. You want to ask them to help out. You want to say, help, 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 help. We can do that to all the great teachers. Jesus, Ram Maharshi, I believe all these teachers are here now. Jesus, Longchenpa, Ram Maharshi, Nanda Maimon, I believe at least those four are here, present in the consciousness of this planet, working very, very much so to help us choose once again. Choose the path of honoring time and set down the path of worshiping time, which is an idolatrous path and leads to great, great misery and regrets, to say the least. So we need to hit a home run right now. It's home run hitting time. And it seems like a lot of, we're in a rally mode. We're rallying here, absolutely rallying. I mean, pulling in by that DeLorean was really something. The DeLorean on the freeway. And I followed it for a while. Finally, I zipped past it. And boy, that car looks old now, I'm telling you. It looks pretty wimpy now, but back then, wow, it was really the hot thing. It looked like a good time travel. That's why they selected it for those movies. And of course, John DeLorean got in all sorts of trouble, I believe, over cocaine. Well, for one reason, right? I mean, cocaine was absolutely crazy in the 80s. Late 70s, 80s. Absolutely nuts. And I think the AIDS epidemic slowed it down because people said, "Hey, you can get on cocaine, you could get a little crazy. You don't care about consequences. You think you're, invulnerable." Of course, it fueled the spread of AIDS actually, because it's just the promiscuous sex that was taking place in the '80s was just completely insane, and so AIDS just spread like wildfire because people just couldn't stop. They couldn't stop. They're on so many drugs. I mean, nitrous, nitrile stuff and nitrous oxide, whatever. All the drugs, poppers, it's cocaine. They just use everything they could possibly use to just keep on partying. They didn't want the party to ever stop. Time worshippers, time worshippers, time worshippers. And then they wandered like Alice in Wonderland. They wandered into the Mad Hatter's Tea Party of artificial intelligence and said, "Wow, this looks like a party," And now we're realizing it's not such a party. It's tyranny. It's tyranny is coming. People collapse, predicting as always the collapse, the collapse of the stock market, the collapse of dollars is the global reserve currency, petrodollar currency, collapse of the debt. The unsustainable debt is going to collapse. There's always people constantly saying that, and of course they all, every single one of them, it seems like, except me, with a few exceptions, they're selling gold. They're selling gold. They're selling precious metals. They got some, they're shills for the gold industry, selling gold. All these doom and gloom sites, they always are have heavily backed and heavily into advising gold, 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 gold. So, you got to wonder, how much that skews their, they're preaching gloom and doom. There's no question about it. But we're not selling gold here at all. Totally different. See, and unfortunately, those doom and gloomers, what they really are selling also is how to make insane profits off the misery of everybody else. That's saying, yeah, if you position yourself properly, when everything collapses, you're going to make an obscene fortune. So they're playing on the greed of everybody is what they're doing. Instead of saying spiritually what we can do, they're just saying, hey, you can be really super greedy and really super rich and just subscribe to my newsletter and blog, whatever, and I'll tell you what stocks to pick, how to profit from the misery of others, so the collapse of all this stuff. And it's a pity. It's an absolute pity. It's just astonishing that that would be their focus, on this terrible troubles that are coming in the world. Is somehow, how can I make, maximum profits off of this? It's ubiquitous. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. Wow, the internet and those. So, all that stuff could happen, but we're not here to make obscene profits out of that. We're here to sidestep it. The problem with those people is that they're keeping you hooked into time worshiping. That's saying, hey, other people's loss can be your gain, and so you got to stick around. See, well, I got all these investments. I got to stick around and see how they do. This is bad advice. If things really hit the fan, we need a plan, and we need another avenue, road to go down. And certainly, it's not seeing, hey, how can I become a billionaire off of, the collapse of all this other stuff? How can I position myself to gain power in this world out of the collapse of other stuff? This is where their consciousness is at, and as most people's consciousness is, this is where it's at. Well, here is completely different. Completely different. He said, how can we go down the path of honoring time? You see, this is what we're interested in. We're not interested in staying, getting rich on the path of worshiping time. We're not interested in that in the slightest bit. And the more, it seems like we would turn our backs on the world, the more the world tries to shower us with gifts, saying, oh, no, don't leave, don't leave, don't leave. This path is great. The path of materialism, great. Come on. Worshiping time is wonderful. I don't know what's next. What kind of gifts can be thrown at me next? And of course, we don't have to figure it out. We'll say, we'll figure it out in hindsight. Just say, no, no thanks. Don't say, well, why? Why not? Well, I got to explain it to you. No, I don't. I said, well, you know, I know saying no is the right thing, but I need hindsight to explain it to a time worshiper, because it's very difficult to explain anything to a time worshiper that they don't agree with. You know, they just become intractable and nasty, and, you know, you don't want to even deal with it at all. So, when hindsight kicks in, we'll, you know, maybe we can go over that. So I was in a store, I was looking at these San Francisco Giant keychains, and then I went to a different part of the store and came back about 20 minutes later. They were all gone, except one of them was on the floor. And I said, what the heck is going on here? I went to talk to the sales clerk. I said, hey, I was just here looking, and there's like 10 keychains or more there, right there, and now they're all gone. Did you sell them to somebody? He said, no. I said, well, someone had to grab them because in their haste, one of them fell to the floor and they didn't bother to pick it up. What kind of person would have, you know, let something fall to the floor like that, obviously, and then just leave it sitting there? And so somebody just came and grabbed them all and took them. No more, gone. No more, gone. Pretty interesting. Giants represent World Series. They represent baseball World Series pretty very strongly, right? I mean, suddenly no more. Suddenly no more. Just someone just grabs no more. This was not a natural act of gradual attrition of selling them. I mean, it might have taken months to sell all those keychains. They're suddenly all gone. So I recognized this, and the clerk said, ah, yeah, we'll look at the video. And store manager, look at the video or something. But so, yeah, okay. For me, it's a World Series, World Serious. Take the World Serious or something. Or, I don't know, it's got some to see that it's been stolen, suddenly gone, stolen from us. You can't get what you want anymore. I wanted to get one. Can't get it. It's gone. There was one left, but at that time, I just soured on it, you know. Maybe that's the last World Series is this year. Something like that. This is the 111. So, I believe from the time of the 111th World Series will be the last World Series. I believe the dream, that's when this whole collapse took place. Or it could mean this is when the distraction is going to take place now. Starting October 27th, 2015, is severe distraction is coming. The worst collapse in history. This is what the Bible tells, that there'll be the worst collapse in tribulation time. The worst falling away from faith, the right path in history will take place, and we're at that time right now, starting October 27th, when the 111th World Series starts. Under the 111th Pope, since St. Malachi's prophecies of saying this will be these are the popes, and this will be the 112th or 111th, depending on if you count John Paul I and II as the same as 109th as one. So this is the time. This is the time. This is the time. This is the time where the distraction is going to hit. And we don't want to go through that, because I already have the experience with the 1980s distraction. Who was president? I think Jimmy Carter. Son. My brother, Billy. You're going to like Billy. Really, really good guy. That's not my best Carter. I used to be able to do Carter really well. I don't want to mess with him. I think he has cancer. You know, well-meaning man, humanitarian, time worshiper. So hopefully he can get well, shift over to honoring time and get well. You know, he's an earnest man. Anyway, I think he was president, was 1980, and then who came in? Was it Bill Clinton? Who came after? God, Reagan? Maybe it was Reagan. Yeah. Then Clinton. I think it was Reagan saying, just, Nancy Reagan saying, just say no to drugs, because we had this raging drug epidemic. As they said, crack cocaine in the mid-80s just became insane, in especially in the cities. I think the some of the, baby boomers were smart enough to stay away from it, but others were not so wise. And it was a hideous, hideous epidemic. It was just the whole AIDS and crack thing, and it was just awful, awful. And hey, here comes, computer stuff. Oh, that's a nice graphic. Smiley stuff. United Nations, they love to use these Illustrator for their all their logos and everything. And you just clean energy. Oh, here's something else that I don't have the actually, maybe I can get something for you here. Just now that we're really cooking, with cooking here. Is UNEP, United Nations Environmental Program, okay? UNEP. I just wanted to prove it to you here. It's really quite extraordinary. Well, I can just tell you. Because this is not, yeah, I don't have it on here. It's on the other hard disk. Okay, fine. The logo for UNEP, United Nations Environmental Program, which is the arm, which is the enforcer arm, okay, of environmental programs, really. The regulator enforcing, they've been pushing this whole climate change. They're the strong force behind it all. Their logo, okay, their logo of UNEP, UNEP, is virtually identical to Christ the Redeemer statue in Rio, okay, Brazil. And I did a video because somebody in Australia, Melbourne, Australia, had this huge balloon of Christ the Redeemer, and I realized that it's associated with gambling, and I had this intuition that this is very important. There's some catastrophe coming involving this symbol somehow. I wasn't sure what it was. Now, of course, with the ISIS thing, with the moon by the Christ Redeemer, the white moon matches the flag of ISIS, so that was part of it. This certainly is a global crisis that's happening with the ISIS, no question, and the refugees from that, and a lot of stuff, the turmoil. But UNEP, the symbol on UNEP is a white circle with this white, a blue circle with a white figure. It's the Christ Redeemer statue, actually. In Rio, which is, of course, Rio is the place where Agenda 21 took birth in 1992. Okay. This is where it all started, in Brazil. And I had a dream years ago where I was shown the whole situation of what's going to happen in the world, the whole thing. It was so intricate, I couldn't figure out what's going on, but I knew it started in Brazil. The whole thing came out of Brazil. Not the Brazilian people necessarily, but it was speaking about, and you look back at the United Nations, the whole climate conference thing, the Sustainable Goals, Agenda 21, all of this. Rio, Brazil. Christ the Redeemer statues on UNEP, that's their logo. Extraordinary. And I said, when you see this logo, look out. In the video, I said, wow, this is going to be trouble. This is the trouble that's coming. Now, we don't know what kind of false flag events could happen, but now we're narrowing it down. I don't have that logo. It's on my other, what do you call it? Outboard hard disk, backup hard disk. And I could actually find it here and give it to you. I wonder if I could do that, because you're going to be quite astonished at that. What kind of thing? I can't pull it directly. So we are narrowing the whole thing down, and it's all coming to light now. So this is, I love doing this work. It's the ultimate detective work here. And the fact that Anonymous Ma would respond after that video last night, when I went to bed with that video last night, my head, my whole psyche was just chung, 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 chung. I realized it just it struck a massive chord, a massive spiritual chord there. And to have that intense dream like this, and it means we're hitting the right chords here. There we go. There it is. Holy cow. Now I have to get a folder to drag this into, and I will drag it in, and I will show you in just a moment. Just hang in there. This is exciting stuff. We can hang in there. Let me just drag it into this folder, just straight there. Okay. Let me see how big this one is. Well, that's big enough. You'll get the idea. Although we'll distort it in this program. We'll end up distorting a little bit, but okay. All right, we're putting it in here. And now I'm going to go over to the pictures. Access denied. What is this? It didn't click in there. It didn't. It didn't go in the folder. That is strange. 1 second, please. And now it's frozen up. Let me do it again. Access is denied. Okay. Okay, let me try it again. Let me try something else. You never know with computers, right? I mean, they're really quite beastly here. Let me see if they'll go into this folder. It did. Okay, found out a way around it. I see pictures of Rana Maharshi, Jesus, and Nanda Maimon in this folder. Interesting. So let's put this over here and add it in, and maybe you can see what I'm talking about. Right. Now, okay, so it's spread out because this program, it makes it into the 60, you know, 9 by 6 ratio, and this was a square ratio, so the graphic is actually spread out horizontally more than normal, but it went in a square format. It's exactly Christ the Redeemer statue. Can you see that in the middle there? That is Christ the Redeemer statue, just spread out more than so how extraordinary is that? How extraordinary is that? United Nations Environmental Programs. And we have this World Cup in Rio, right? And what was that, last year, 2014? And they keep showing Christ the Redeemer statue. They're cutting to it during the finals. And the moon coming up, this white moon. You see that white moon? Isn't that the white moon is the symbol of ISIS, right? On their flag, the white moon. Pretty amazing detective work going on here. What do we have here? Those are looking at some other stuff here. Maybe something that might interest you, interest us. Not exactly. What's this? I have a lot of pictures here. Wow. There's one of these is my famous picture, actually. It was pretty famous. Famous within a small circle of people. Sacred scenery, pictures of sacred scenery. Here's one. So we enjoy this video here. Okay. There you go. Poppies. This might be the one that there you go. It's not quite impressive in being this small. When it's big, you realize that the vast expanse here just completely covered with poppies. full stop in the wow here. Okay, so there's a bunch of pictures here. Speaking of troublesome times coming, this is probably what we're facing right now, is this right here. Look at that terrain, okay? Check out this terrain right here. Check out that terrain. That's the devil's playground, or devil's something in Death Valley. This is a close-up of it, and there you go. You don't want to be walking out or driving along this, right? This is the future right now, okay? This is what the time worshippers are looking at. And they're saying, oh, this is great. This is wonderful. Gonna just see if what else I can give you just to help the mood out here. We're looking for a vibe here, okay? We're looking for some kind of vibe, and so I'm just trying to throw this stuff your way. We need to start catching a vibe, if you know what I'm saying. Don't worry about explaining it in hindsight. You know, in hindsight, we'll explain it, but we don't need to explain it right now. Let hindsight worry about explaining it. All right, here's something. I don't know if this will go in there or not. Maybe not. Okay. Oh, it did. Okay. Here's an interesting thing. That distorts it a little bit. Throwing something. Look at that. What is that? You know. Catching it. Maybe he's coming back, catching it, throwing it. Interesting. We have to catch this vibe that we can do it. We can do it. We can do this. Just hang in here for a moment. These are all... Who knows what we discover? You have to sort of start take this attitude. Like a collage. What's this collage doing here? What's going on here? Let me throw this in here. That's all the pictures of Ananda Maima. It's a collage of them. I had these pictures. It's a collage. I actually did see that. Look at that. Those are all individual pictures. Interesting. We're coming across this here. Maybe the dream foreshadowed this, actually. Similar to the dream. See? Okay, well, anyway. Oh, here's some more. I don't know. Well, what do we have here? Some interesting... Yeah, here's some interesting pictures, too. Let me see. Pull this one in. Let me just pull this one in. Has a good vibe right there. Very spiritual vibe. This is slightly distorted. This graphic, this program puts it into one picture format only. So it slightly distorts the look of the picture. This one might be a little less distorted. Yeah, that was less distorted. Interesting. We should have asked, you know, we should have asked, hey, can you show us this option? We were too out of it. The world was too out of it back then. This is the trouble. The world was too out of it. Did not recognize the trouble for what it was, but now we do recognize the trouble. Guaranteed that we would have been set straight if we would have asked. Would have said, oh yeah, okay. This, you don't want to go down this road. And here's the one you do want to go down. We would have been set straight, that is for sure. The resolution on that one is not good. Let's try this resolution. This one. There you go. So this would have set us straight. You want to see someone who knows the truth, who can set you straight on which path to go, and to avoid the bad one, and to take the right one. You're looking at that consciousness right here, expressing through a body, you know. Absolutely been set straight on that. So, we have an option now to be set straight on this. You know, that's very important. I feel we can pick up this option. Pick up the option. It's like a contract, you know. We signed a contract. We still have this option available. And we're not going to be like, you know, tortured and whipped, are you idiots? No, I say, hey, great. You know, I bet you, the teachers are going to say, hey, thank God you woke up in time. You know, and this is the whole plan. And now you can get it right. This is what we want. So they're thrilled. They're overjoyed. You know. Waking up in time, catching this in the nick of time like this, and recognizing, oh, mistakes. They're all about helping us correct our mistakes. That's the whole point. They know we're going to make mistakes. And they are all about helping us correct our mistakes and choosing once again, choosing rightly, this time in a way what we really want. This is what it's all about. I'm just looking here at some more pictures. These don't have the right aspect ratio, as far as I can tell here. Yeah, none of them do. None of them have the right aspect ratio. So they'll get distorted in this particular program. That's fine. That's enough. Alright. Just sort of winding this down, adding, embellishing, getting familiar with what's possible. Here's one. Let's see what this one can do. Different look. I don't know what the... oh yeah, there you go. See, this one was... This being was not fooled by the world. Okay, I guarantee you this, not fooled by the world whatsoever. Perfectly aware of the differentiation between the worshiping time and honoring time, the two different paths, you know, and saying one leads to a massacre, you know, flee the massacre. This one was perfectly aware of all of this. And still in the world here, 1982, post IBM PC 5150, post AIDS epidemic, in the midst of the cocaine epidemic, etc., still here in the world, willing to help us out. How about that? How about that? So, I mean, this is someone we could go to and say, hey, you remember the 80s? I remember the early 80s, the 70s, the 80s. You remember how tough it was? Well, I messed up. I messed up. And could you help me out? They say, sure, I know exactly what you're talking about. You can be absolutely certain that this awareness knows exactly what we're talking about, and the difficulty we had at the time seeing clearly. They would say, yeah, of course I know the difficulty you had. Of course I was aware of it. Absolutely, 100%, very clear about it. And I cannot completely understand how you would have trouble then. And that's what I'm here. I was here to help you with, right? So, knowing that we were going to screw up, but not giving up on us, so to speak. Now, of course, Jesus is back as well. Ramaharshi, Longchenpa, these are the great teachers. They all are have the same clarity. They all have the same clarity. The interesting fact is that this one, Nandamayama, was actually here in the world, bodily, so to speak, with appearance, during the times that we made the wrong choice. So it seems, fitting that we might go back and say, could you at least introduce us to the right choice and get us going on that? And from Dreamwise, I see there's a response to this. But I'll take, whoever can help us, actually. I'm not partisan, to any of these teachers in particular. I'm partisan to all of them, actually. But whoever's most effective at helping us, then let's get going right now, right here, right now. Let's get going right here, right now. So hopefully this you're getting more warmed up to this. You got to thaw out to this, thaw out to this. Is we have options. We have this opportunity. We've got something going here. We're doing the right detective work. We're digging into the and we're realizing, holy cow, it was all right there in front of us actually. 5150. What a name. What a way to name a computer. Introduce artificial intelligence with the 5150 motif, which is an extremely dangerous, psychotic maniac. Danger to themselves and everybody else. Yeah. Nice. Very appropriate. Right? Very nice way to introduce artificial intelligence. But we were so messed up at the time, globally, consciousness-wise. We kind of missed it then, but we're not missing it now. And all that counts is, that we get it so we can correct our mistake. So we're getting it. We are getting it. We are getting it now. What's next? Wow, I can hardly wait. I can hardly wait till June, Surfing Safari. I saw Surfing USA, but so yeah, I can't wait for June. We're on Safari to stay. Tell the teacher we're surfing USA. We're going down the right path, you see. We're going down the right path now. We're planning out a route to go down the right path now. All right? So stay tuned. Stay tuned to this YouTube channel because, popcorn is popping here. Okay. And maybe if you listen to music, maybe listen to some of that stuff in 1980, the good stuff. Most of the stuff was, Disco Inferno. Come on. I don't know what to listen to. But let us start catching the vibe, saying, wait a minute, the vibe of the world right now, no thanks. This is what I've been trying to do, is trying to, say, hey, at some point we need to shift our vibe off of the future or the path that artificial intelligence is showing us and get back to vibe where before we chose that, forgive ourselves for choosing that because it was just an idle flirtation. Okay, all right, it's flirtation. All right, we're done with the flirtation now, okay? Now we're getting back to business here. Now we're getting back to honoring the business of honoring time, which needs to be done in a very spiritually intelligent fashion. Spiritual wisdom is involved, the Holy Spirit's involved entirely with this. This has to get done with. We need to be to do it and be done with it, honoring time. So back to serious business now. Back to the future, or back to the past, you know, is, I don't know which way you want, you know, back to the future, we're going back to the future, which way is it going? Well, we know where we're going, back to serious business. Okay, stay tuned, we'll see what's next, that's it. Well, try it again. Click it. That's it. No, it didn't want to stop. I don't know why it didn't stop. I clicked it. It didn't stop. That's interesting. Wow. That's the first time that's happened. Clicked it and it didn't stop. Okay, let's stop it another way. Let's take a look at this intensity right here. Let's take a look and see if a picture comes up or not. Maybe it doesn't. Wow. What's happened here? And now no video comes up at all. And now it doesn't work. Okay, well, I'm gonna pull the plug on this.